お世話になっております。サラです。So today we're going to talk about 敬語, which is formal Japanese. We're going to go through four expressions that are used a lot. 敬語 is usually used in business situations or by service workers. So it's not that necessary for foreigners to know. But these four expressions are very useful. So at the very least, you should remember them. Number one, お世話になっております。お世話になっております is a greeting, and the closest way to translate it would probably be hello. Now, 世話 means to take care of something. So a direct translation could be something like, thank you for taking care of me. But お世話になっております is used in the same way as hello would be in English. It's used instead of hello in business settings, whether that's talking face to face, on a phone call, or writing an email. Number two.申し訳ございません。This is a very formal way to say I'm sorry. If you want to apologize to someone at work, you will have to say 申し訳ございません。Now, Japanese people use this word a lot because Japanese people apologize all the time. What you need to remember is that if you want to say that you're very sorry, you cannot say とても申し訳ございません because とても is not 敬語. It's either大変申し訳ございません where 大変 means very or 誠に申し訳ございません where 誠に means truly Number three かしこまりましたかしこまりました is a very formal way to say okay or I got it and it's usually used in customer service so you might hear it when you're for example ordering at a Japanese restaurant but it's almost exclusively used with customersBecause it's actually too polite to use with your own colleagues. So you wouldn't use it when speaking to people at your own company. Number four. お待ちください。The verb 待つ means to wait. So お待ちください is a polite way to say, please wait. If you want to ask someone for some time in a business situation or in the service industry, you will use this expression. Now you will usually say either,少々お待ちください where 少々 means a little. So it means, please wait a second. Or, しばらくお待ちください where しばらく means a while. So it means, please wait a while. As you might have noticed, 敬語 is very different from non-formal Japanese. So it might seem a bit confusing in the beginning. But if you just remember these four phrases, you're off to a very good start.I hope you learned something new, and if you have any questions, you'll see them in the comment section below.
これからも役に立つ動画を作っていきたいと思うので、もしよかったら登録してください。バイバイ!